And let me tell you something about a rain-shortened race, which the 2003 500 was. The dominant car very rarely wins a rain-shortened race because, you know, you've got the fastest car. You're not going to worry about strategy. You're going to just worry about winning. And on that day, we've seen a lot of upset winners in a rain-shortened race. Just look back to July of 2019 when Haley won. You wouldn't have seen that one coming, right? The same thing on that day could have very well happened. But my team did an amazing job of knowing that we could be racing just past halfway, understanding the rain and the weather, and then putting us in a position to be out front when the rain is. Think about this. If you know it's a 200 lapper, you know how to win at lap 200. But when there's weather in the area and it's going to be rain shortened, especially as short as this one was, I think 110 is the laps we went, something like that. How do you know? How do you plan for that? You don't know when it's going to rain. But that particular day, we did an awesome job of being up front all day. There was a late restart, and I was in second. I think Jimmy Johnson was leading, but I'm not sure. But I know Dale Jr. was on the inside, a lap down. He had had an issue with his battery. And right behind him was Christian Fittipaldi. So we're riding around coming to get the green flag, and this is a pivotal restart. This is the end. And when we're coming around, I'm assessing things. I'm thinking, okay, Jimmy will get a good start. Was it Jimmy? I think it was Jimmy. Somebody good was leading. Jimmy's pretty good. And then Dale Jr. was on the inside. And I was like, okay, Jimmy will get a good start. Dale will get a good start. Christian Fittipaldi, he's sort of a rookie. He doesn't know all this. So if I do my job, when the leader breaks and Dale breaks, I'll be able to jump to the inside as soon as we cross the start-finish line, get behind Dale, because I didn't think Christian would get a good start, and he didn't. Get behind Dale, push Dale past the leader, and grab the lead. That was my plan. That's how I had it pictured working. And when the green flag flew, everything worked just like I had thought it would. And I got down in behind Dale, pushed by to the lead, and I think a few laps later, somebody wrecked, and the caution came out. And then while the caution was out, it rained. And that move, a move that, you know, wasn't as dramatic as Denny Hamlin's 2016 pass up in turn four when he grabbed his checkered flag, but it was technical and it was precise and it was well thought out and well executed. And I'm really proud of that move, because that it was hard to pass in 03. There wasn't a lot of passing. You had to really think things out. And we were able to think out, execute, and be leading when the rains came.